Was Obi Toppin a little too honest? We're going to take a closer look at exactly what he said after his first career start, coming up next, right here on Riding with the Knicks. Welcome back to Riding with the Knicks. This is the channel where we talk about the team that we love, the New York Knicks, the season as it unfolds, and the deeper themes that we can pull out and apply to our lives to be the best version of ourselves. Hey, if you're here for the first time and that sounds like a channel that you'd like to subscribe to, that you'd like to see more videos from, I'm asking you, take a second right now, hit that subscribe button. It's a small commitment for you, the viewer, but it means a lot to me as the creator. And so I invite you to subscribe to this channel. Also, if you end up liking this video, then hit the like button. If you don't like this video, don't hit the like button. I don't know why people out here asking for likes all the time. If somebody doesn't like something, they don't like something. But let me know your feedback also in the comments below, how I can make this channel better. It's a brand new channel. Or also your feedback on the topic at hand today. Obi's first career start, and not actually his play on the court. A lot of people will probably talk about that and break that down. I don't think it was anything spectacular, but really what I want to talk about is his first career post-game press conference after his start. Because he said some things, and we're going to look at two clips from that press conference. He said some things that made me feel like, ooh, maybe that was a little too honest. And so what is too honest? You know, like, we got people that, claims that they're just honest, but they end up just being, like, really mean and rude. It's like a cover for them to, like, say really hurtful things. And they use the term brutally honest. It's like, well, no, you're just being an a-hole. But then you got people on the other side of the spectrum that, like, are really open and honest about their mistakes and, like, what they wish they had done better. And, like, it just seems like they're a humble and free person. And that's just a really beautiful version of honesty and humility. And so honesty could be this beautiful thing, but it could also be this really, like, hurtful, painful thing. But I think in competition and in sports, honesty could be a little bit of, like, a chink in your armor. It could be, like, a little bit of, like, showing your soft underbelly, you know, like, to the opposition. And I feel like that's kind of how two of these comments came out. And so the two comments we're going to look at are, one, he was raving about KD, and two, he gave a little bit of insight into the team and his personal work ethic this year, which might be leading to poor results on the floor. So let's take a look at the first clip right here.
It's basketball. You can't just say, I'm going to run to this elbow, unless you're KD or someone like that who can do that. But you can't just say, I'm going to run to this elbow, be open, and shoot the ball.
All right. I said he was raving about KD. Maybe I was exaggerating a little bit, but to have a guy who's in the NBA, Obi Toppin, who worked his tail off, who like grinded to get there, spent an extra year in college, became a college player of the year, went to the Mecca to play basketball, got picked 8th overall, like, you're not a nobody, bro. And so he's talking about, like, well, I can't, nobody, like, we have to read and react. You can't just walk to the elbow and shoot a jump, well, unless you're KD. You know, like, bro, keep it in your pants a little bit. Like, unless you're KD, like, okay, yeah. I'm not under some delusion that, like, Obi Toppin is KD, like Kevin Durant, or Obi Toppin is, like, the next Kobe Bryant. Like, I'm not saying that at all, but, like, come on, man. Like, you have respect for this guy, and Obi Toppin comes off as, like, such a likable and respectable guy. Like, and I praise that kind of behavior. And who the hell am I to comment on it? You know, I'm just giving my impression. But, like, I think that what it shows is not only that he has respect for KD, but it's like, I see myself in a totally different category than this guy. But there are other players who probably don't have the skills that Kevin Durant has, but their heart is, I'm here too for a reason. And or their guts, or their, like, their confidence is, I can walk to the elbow and shoot a jumper. Like, yeah, like, I'm on the same court as this guy. Like, that's a different mentality. And I don't think it's delusional to think, like, hey, I'm here for a reason, and on any given night I could play better than you. I think that that's a type of, like, drive that makes the greats great. And I think Obi can be great. And I think too many players nowadays don't have a humility. They don't have a respect for other players. But, like, I don't know if, I'm not saying he shouldn't feel that way about Kevin Durant, but I'm saying that at a press conference post game, maybe a show, like, if you were the opposition, like, if you were the opponent, who was about to play Obi the next game, and you saw him say this about Kevin Durant, what would you do? Would you say, oh, I'm going to exploit that? Like, or would you just say, oh, wow, like, would it just roll off your back? I guess I felt like he was a little too honest. Like, maybe that's not where you give respect and you give praise. Who knows? The second clip is maybe a little bit more concerning for fans or concerning for the team, really. So let's roll that clip and then we'll talk about it.
I'm not going to say I don't have confidence in my shot. Every time I shoot it, like, obviously, I think it's going to go in, but it's just a matter of just putting in the time. I got to get in the gym a lot more at night. Like if we practice in the morning, I got to get in the gym a lot more at night, put up shots and just like the more work I put into my game, like the better it's going to be. So
I feel like last year, every single game, we saw videos and clips on YouTube, on Twitter, on Instagram, everywhere, of the Knicks players in an empty gym getting up extra shots. Like, I remember seeing, like, Julius Randle getting up shot after shot after shot. I remember seeing R.J. Barrett getting up shot after shot after shot. Thibodeau talking about R.J. Barrett, setting up the gun that shoots him the ball to shoot those corner threes right in front of Thibodeau's office. Like, that was the storyline. I remember IQ getting up deep threes in an empty Madison Square Garden. Like, we saw those videos all the time. But here we have Obi Toppin saying, like, man, yeah, we got to get back in the gym. I have to get back in the gym late night. If he's saying that, man, that means that culture is no longer part of the Knicks routine, to get in the gym late. We don't see evidence of it, and we don't see evidence on the floor of it. And we've got now a player who's saying, like, I got to get back to that. Which means that, going back to the first point, if you have mutual respect for a star, like, I'm not saying don't have that, but, like, that ought to, and if you see yourself in a different class than that person, that's true. He's seeing the truth. But that should motivate you to get into the gym. Like, remember the storyline about Randall? Like, it was that Kobe Bryant took him to this small, like, high school or middle school or whatever gym when they got off the plane in, like, I don't know, some Midwestern city that there's nothing to do. Or maybe it was, I don't remember the exact specifics, but, like, Kobe Bryant put that in Julius Randle, like, get in the gym, even the day that you land in a new city, set up some kind of open gym for yourself and get in there and get up shots. Like, the greats, Kobe Bryant's one of the great greats, and he was grinding when nobody else was looking. And so our team, the Knicks, last year, were grinding, and nobody else was looking, but then people started looking, you know, like, because we've got all these videos now, and it goes up, the clips go up and stuff like that. But it was a contract year for a lot of guys. And so it kind of sucks that, like all you need is one leader that's going to say, no, I'm staying in the gym late tonight. That's motivating for other guys. Like, Obi can actually be that guy. Maybe Julius isn't that guy. Maybe he was last year, and maybe he's not this year. But, like, Obi, you can be that guy. Like, you can say, like, no, I'm going to be the one that stays in the gym late, whether you stay with me or not. And I feel like if you had that respect for KD, like, hey, I can't walk to the elbow and just shoot a J, but I will someday. Because I'm in the gym every single night, hey, I think that's a different story. But when you see both of these clips together, like, that guy's in a different class than me, and I'm not really doing the extra unseen work to get to that spot. If it's the truth, it's the truth. But maybe that's not the venue to share that truth. Because as a fan, I'm like, yeah, no duh. This is what we're seeing. And so, I love the Knicks. I love Obi Toppin. I don't want any of those guys that got picked around his number in the draft. I'm out here, I want Obi Toppin to get all the minutes in the world. Like, I want Obi Toppin to know, like, yo, the team and the fans love this guy. Like, you hear everybody chant Obi. You see it all over Twitter, all over Instagram, everywhere. Like, people adore this kid. And so I'm in that same boat. Like, I love this kid too. You know, maybe I'm seeing this thing wrong, and if I am, let me know. I'm open to that. But I'm just making a video, making a couple comments about honesty and, like, where is it appropriate? Where is it maybe too much? I think in competition, there are things that you can maybe say that are going to put you at a disadvantage. And I think this might be those. Like, these two examples might be that. I think in life, for you and me, who maybe might not be starting for the Knicks tonight, I think that we're going to probably want to err on the side of being honest. I hope I'm not making a video that's encouraging you to be like, oh, well, maybe I don't want to be too honest in my life. Like, I think in competition, it's one thing. I think in the world, like, we don't have enough honesty. Like, I don't think we have enough people that are like, I'm not where I want to be, but I am going to grind to get there, and I'm going to be open about the process. And when we see people like that, I think that that ends up being that, like, really motivational, like, inspiring type of person. And so don't be somebody who falls into the class of like, hey, I'm just being honest, but you're really being an a-hole. And don't fall into the class of people that's like, I have to hide all of my inadequacies from the world, because if I let them see the real me, they're going to reject me. That's not freeing either. And so I'm going to try to get to the place where I'm open and honest about the process. And that honesty and that process and the gap between where I am and where I want to be is going to motivate me to, like, get in the gym late and get up extra shots. And so I guess, if anything, I feel like I learned something valuable from watching that post-game press conference. I love this team. I love the Knicks. We're like 17 and 20. Last year we were 20 and 20. So it really isn't that different. But it just feels different, right? The energy feels different. The excitement feels different. I've been calling for changes to be made in the lineup. Changes are made and nothing really changes. So it indicates that there's something deeper going on about this team. And so this is the channel called Riding with the Knicks, because I'm always going to be riding with the Knicks. I'm riding with the Knicks. I'm riding with Obi. And I believe that you are too. And so, again, if you're here for the first time and you like this video, you like this concept of, like, tracking the team but also pulling out deeper themes, I just invite you to hit the subscribe button. If you liked my takes on this video, hit the like button. And I'd love to hear from your comments. I respond to every single comment because the channel is so young. I can get to everything right now. So I'd love to talk with you. I'd love to meet you. And so thank you so much for watching this video. More to come very soon in the future. Until next time, go Knicks.